Do you want to convert your videos at lightning speed? Good, keep on watching then. Hi, I'm Dan from Wondershare UniConverter. Video converting can be time consuming, and especially when you do a lot of it, the amount of time a software can crank out a video becomes a very important factor. In the paid version of the Wondershare UniConverter 13, you get the option to use high-speed conversion. What it does is use CPU and GPU acceleration, and if both are available, the UniConverter will automatically choose the most optimal mode based on available hardware and file format. Alright, let's get into converting. Now, I went scuba diving a few years back and I just came across this footage I shot on a GoPro. It's pretty long and therefore large in size, so I'm gonna convert it for more simple use across the internet. So after opening up the Wondershare UniConverter 13, I'll go to convert, but the high-speed conversion is also available for the merger. First, let's turn on the high-speed conversion mode up here. It'll give you a little disclaimer on the kind of file types it supports, so read that first and then click turn on. I'm actually going to trim it down a little and choose a part that's a bit more than just hazy underwater footage. I also want the output format to be only 720p, but if I wanted, I could choose from many presets or use custom settings. And just so you could see the difference between normal and high-speed conversion, I'll split the screen and do a side-by-side comparison. What you see here is at 4x speed. So how long does it usually take for you to convert a 10-minute long video, and what kind of videos do you usually convert? Let us know in the comment section below. Bam! With the high-speed conversion mode turned on, it finished in 1 minute and 22 seconds. While in normal mode, it completed the task almost 3 times slower in 3:30. That is a huge difference in my opinion. And the time difference becomes even more relevant if you try to convert longer videos, not to mention entire movies. So there you go, I think the high-speed conversion mode is a really neat function, and it's definitely worth giving it a shot. Alright, if you found this video helpful, please give it a big thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe to the channel for more video-related content. Also, should you have any questions, feel free to ask us in the comment section below, we're happy to reply. With that being said, thank you so much for watching, and I'm going to see you in the next video.